Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Moment of Growth and Transformation with Tosin Opeoluwa. Today, I'm just going to talk briefly on how to know when gifting is becoming exploitation. A lot of people love to give, including me. And when you see people that really love to give, initially, they don't think about if other people are trying to exploit them, they just give and give, give. And so it gets to a point where they are tired of being the one giving alone without having someone giving back to them, especially in a love relationship. If I have someone who claims to love me so much, and then I'm only giving to them, they are not giving anything back to me, it's a big problem and it's a red flag. Now, how do I know that giving is becoming exploitation? Number one, they love to split bills every time. And this comes because they know that I will say, "Oh, don't worry, I'll take care of it." So they continue to do that, especially people who are dating in the Western world. Number two, they always forget their wallets when it's time to pay. I've seen a lot of people complaining about this. They go to the store, they both buy things, then when it's time to pay, the man will say, "Oh, I forgot my wallet." Don't fall for it. Your giving is becoming exploit. Here's the thing. Most of the time, people that play upon your emotions of giving, because for some people, giving is attached to emotion. Actually, when we are logical, for people who are logical, you can hardly exploit them when it comes to their money. But when the other person who is trying to play you already realize that, "Oh, if I just do this, she will do this," then for those people, they are playing upon you. So they will always tell you they forgot their wallet. Number three, they will always call you for urgent need. They are always somewhere stranded every time. So they need to call somebody for help. And that person they are calling for help is you. You need to be careful about that. Your giving is becoming exploitation. I'm not saying people don't get stranded. Yes, people do. However, when it's not the first time, it's not the second time, it's not the third time, it's not the fourth time, they know that your giving is probably becoming an exploit or exploitation, as the case may be. Number four, they will lament about their need simply because they know you are a very kind person and you are going to come up with a solution. And usually, part of your solution will be, "Okay, I have this. I can afford to give you this." For this kind of people, when you become tired and you don't want to do that anymore, they are going to be the one that tell you, one, "Well, I did not ask you. You chose to do it," right? That's what they will say. The second thing those people will say that is common to them is, "What are you doing with your home money?" Because they were actually the one taking this money from you that makes you not to think about investing for your whole life, that makes you not to think about buying something for yourself. They keep taking and taking and taking from you, making it difficult for you to even change your underwears sometimes. You need to be careful with those people. You really need to be careful. They are taking advantage of your giving is becoming exploitation. The last thing I'm going to talk about on how to know when your giving is becoming exploitation is they target the time that you will get paid and they will either visit you or request a loan. When you see people doing this number one, number two, number three, number four, five, six, seven, eight, nine times, you should know that they are taking advantage of your giving. It's an exploit, especially in a so-called love relationship. You are in a love relationship. You are not in an exploitation relationship. You don't want people to reward you with sex. You want people to reward you, the person that call themselves your
happy. You want them to reward you with values, with respect, with solutions, with their intellect. You want them to reward you that way. So when you see a man who is always trying to use sex to reward you, just to cover what they are doing to you by exploiting you. And guess what? Research shows that about 70% of people whose spouses engages in extramarital affairs, it comes from the enabling attitude of their wife. Because why? You have really supported them when you should allow them to walk. And that is what brings me to the solution right now, what to do. Because these people, sometimes they are doing these things unconsciously. I'm talking to the singles right now. I'm not talking to the married people. No, I am not talking to the married people. I'm talking to my single ladies right now, especially women who thought, oh, I've been late. I'm over 30. I'm over 40. Let me use money, gifts, and sex to keep him. No, you're not going to keep him that way, because you are not, like one of my guests on the show once said, you can't keep a man who does not want to be kept. So you're only going to keep a man who is willing to be kept, who is willing to do all it takes to see you as a woman of virtue, as a woman of value, want to keep you by all means. Okay? So what should you do when you see a man is taking advantage of your giving and exploiting you? Number one, address it. Communication is very, very key. It's very, very important. And the thing is, when you refuse to communicate some of these things before you get married and you think, oh, Christian ladies, you know, I smile when a number of Christian ladies will tell me, oh, I love him and I'm trying to help his ministry. No, you're not God. You are not going to help him with money. If he has a need, let him cry to God, who is able, the Father of lights, who is able to provide, who is sufficient, who is El Shaddai, the multi-breasted God, is able to provide. He is a sufficient God. So when you are taking the place of God, you are going to pay for it in marriage. So if you take the place of God as the provider for a man who should be the one to provide for you, then you are going to take the punishment of being a God in another person's life. Number one, address it, communicate, address it, raise their conscious awareness. For some people, you see, they actually don't know that what they are doing was associated with their upbringing. A number of them see their parents, their uncles do some of these things. They take from the woman. They don't mind letting the woman become whatever she wants to be, but they sit back, cross their leg, fold their hands, and take all the woman is working for, and they call it support. That is not support. That is exploitation. Sisters, wake up. It is called exploitation. Don't fall for it. Address it. Raise their conscious awareness. Number two, that's demanding from them. I have this uncle, and we were talking one day, and he said, look, one of the ways to actually know a man that is responsible and willing to love you all the days of his life is his giving habits. He must be able to give to you. He must be able to spoil you, and you must be able to ask. So learn to ask, because everyone who asketh receives it. Right? That's what the Bible says. So don't let your home be different. Come on, ask. When you have a need, please do ask. Ask the man. He's the man. Let him be the man. Allow him to be the man. Allow him to be the man. Number three, tell them to find a job. If they don't have a job, and that is probably the reason why they are depending so much on you. Let me tell you this. There is no man, no man, that you try and raise all by your power that will not turn back and bite you. And you can correct me if I'm wrong. You can give me examples. You can let me know in the comment section below the people you have seen, the women you have seen that really helped their husband. And at the end of the day, those men does not eventually cheat on them. Let me know in the comment section below if you have seen people like that, or if you have seen single ladies like that whose partner, the so-called partner, don't end up cheating on them with younger girls or girls that are not even up to their standard. Why? Because you are not allowing him to be a man. So he can't provide for you. And so because he can't provide for you, he looks for someone lesser than you who he will be able to provide for, because that is where his strength is as a man. So if you continue to provide for a man, you're not helping him. As a matter of fact, do not help him to start a business except you are going to be a stakeholder and a shareholder in that business. Don't do it. It's going to come back to you. As a lady, if you have money, invest your money. Invest into your future. When you get married eventually to the man, you can put the money together and start a business together. The business that you understand specifically. If we're not changing, we are not going to be growing. If we're not growing, we can't experience transformation. And if we don't experience transformation, every other areas of our lives will suffer for it. When we grow, when we transform, everything around us transforms. Our finances will transform. Our love life will transform. Our relationships will transform. Our network will transform. Our spiritual life will transform. And that is why I'm crying to the young ladies, to the singles right now. Do everything. A good marriage is possible. A good family is possible. But you have to do all it takes to set things right from the beginning. If you set things straight from the beginning, every other thing becomes easier for you. I hope this episode blessed some. Let me know what you had to say about this in the comment section below. And I'll see you next time. Bye for now.